Hello students, as we have started with the grammar section and I think we have completed with the first lesson, that is parts of speech, and now we'll be moving to the second lesson. Before starting with this lesson, I would like to tell you what is grammar. Children, we all are learning grammar, but do you know what is the exact definition or what is a grammar? Grammar is nothing but it is a system, or we can say it is a structure, and we use this grammar. It has some certain rules over here that how to use these grammatical words in the sentences, means daily how we are going to use these words in the sentences, and they have some rules over here. And if you know this grammar very properly, it will improve your English language. So grammar, it is one part and it is like one system, or we can say it is a structure, and also it has some rules. So how to use these grammatical words, grammar words in the sentences. So as we have completed with the first lesson, parts of speech, I will be sending you the definition as well as some examples of parts of speech, and then you can write it in your grammar notebook. Now the second lesson is, we are going to move to the second lesson, that is sentences. See children, now as we have started with this new lesson, that is sentences. This is lesson number 2, sentences. Children, if I write some words, suppose if I write like this, is careful he. I have written all these words anyhow, means they all are not arranged properly. I have written somewhere else, and we can see first I have written the word is, I have written careful, and then I have written he. So these all are the jumbled words and they are not arranged properly. But if I write the same sentence in this way, he is careful, and I have put a full stop. Now if you see, compared to this first sentence and if you see this second sentence, the first sentence the words are there but they are not arranged properly, and they do not have any meaning, means that they does not have a complete sense or a meaning. But if you see the second sentence as compared to the first one, the second sentence is, in this sentence we can see the words are arranged very properly, and we can see the sentence is also meaningful, means we get some meaning through this sentence. If you see here, the first thing is what? Here the speaker of the sentence is saying, suppose he, and now this word always the before in the sentence we say the sentence begins with the capital letter, the whatever word is there, that word, it starts with the capital letter. Then second, it has a verb, and then the rest of the words are arranged very properly, and all the sentences are, they are ending with either with full stop or with a question mark or with an exclamation mark. So these are some of the rules while writing the sentence. Now what I told, what is a sentence? A sentence, here it is given, see the definition is given. A sentence is a group of words which makes a complete sense. I told you these are the group of words. Here we have written, see, suppose I have taken the example from here, he is careful. These words, these are the group of words and they are arranged very properly. So these are the group of words which makes a complete sense, means it gives something meaning through this sentence. So what is the definition for sentence? That a sentence is a group of words which makes a complete sense. Now children, if you see, suppose if I write like this, suppose now they have told in a definition that they are the group of words which make complete sense. But if I will write the word wait, W-A-I-T, wait, I have written the word wait. So what can you understand from this word that I told you to wait? Means you are going to understand that this somebody is speaking to you or somebody is telling you to wait. So sometimes what happens, we say now we have, I have told you that sentence is what? A group of words which makes complete sense. But if you see here, only one word is there. Wait, but through this word also, I can understand some meaning that somebody has told me to wait. Or for example, we can take the other word also. Here they have given stop. They have given the word stop. Here also I can say, we can say this word, this stop or this wait, this is also meaningful because here somebody is telling you something and it is meaningful. Means I can understand that somebody is telling me to wait or somebody is telling me to stop. Means this is also a meaningful word, we can say. So sometimes what happens, all the time we can't say that the group of words which has which makes complete sense is called a sentence. Sometimes what happens, only one word, suppose only one word, I have taken example, wait or stop, they can also make sense. Okay, and we can understand here, we come to know that somebody is trying to tell you something. So this is also a meaningful word, we can say. It is not necessary the sentence is only meaningful, even the words are also meaningful. So what they have told, a sentence is a group of words which makes complete sense. And again, what they have told, again, see, sometimes a sentence may have only one word. Sometimes you may have only one word. They have given like this. If somebody says to you, stop, you know what he means. If somebody tells you that, stop, so you will come to know that, somebody has told me to stop. See, children, sometimes in the class, teacher, she says, stand up, or she says, stop, she says, wait. Or she may tell some other words, go. So these are also some of the words, they are single words, but they have something meaning for that. That one word also makes complete sense, and they, even for that word also we can call it as a sentence. So you and try to understand what is the difference between these, that a sentence may have, may, a sentence is what? A group of words which makes complete sense. Also, a one word also makes complete sense, and that also we can call it as a sentence. Now, I will write some of the sentences. You can see here, kinds of sentences. Now, we are going to learn what are the kinds of sentences. Children, you just see. Next, we are going to see kinds of sentences. I am going to write those four sentences over here. See, first one is, he is careful, full stop. Second is he careful, and question mark. Next is, be careful, here just a full stop. Then last is, how careful he is. Now, through all these four sentences, we are going to learn here the kinds of sentences. I have given here four different sentences. The words are same. Through all the words, I want to tell the word, we can say careful. We can focus the main word, that is careful, over here. And through all these four sentences, we are going to study four kinds of sentences. Now, if you see the first sentence, he is careful. If you see the first sentence, here see, he is careful. Now, if you see this sentence, what it is, children? The first sentence states something. Sentences like this are called as statement or declarative sentence. He is careful. We are telling something about this subject. We are telling something about he, that he is careful. When we are telling something, or when we are declaring something about someone else, or where we are telling something, when we are stating something about someone else, now we are talking about he. He is careful means I am telling something, information about this he, or I am declaring something about this he, or a noun, or we can say I am stating something about this he. So this kind of sentence is called as declarative sentence, or we can say statements. So first type of sentence is declarative sentence. So first type of sentence is declarative sentence, because it is stating something or it is declaring something about he. Means I am telling something about he. I am telling that he is careful. I am stating something about he. When we are telling something about someone, or when we are declaring something about someone, that sentence, that kind of sentence is called as declarative sentence. I hope you are clear with this. Now second, if you see, is he careful? Now here what I am doing, I am asking a question to you. I am asking a question to you that is he careful? I am asking about the, question about him, that is he careful? Means I am asking about him, that I am asking about something information about him. So is he careful? Means when I am asking the question, that type, that kind of sentence is called as interrogative sentence. That is called as interrogative sentence. Okay. So first one is declarative sentence, because we are telling something about someone, so that's why it is called as declarative sentence. Second is what? Here I am asking a question. So when we are asking a question about someone, if you want to get an answer, if you want to get some information about someone, then that kind of sentence is called as interrogative sentence. If you see the third sentence, that is be careful. Now suppose if any child is running on the stairs, or he is jumping over from the stairs, so what I will tell him, be careful, means I am giving an order. Okay, I am commanding that child that you should be careful while walking or while running or while playing. So I am giving a command, I am giving some order. So that kind of sentence is called as imperative sentence. So this is the third kind of sentence. This is the third kind of sentence, means when we give a command or when we give an order, or sometimes what happens, even we request also, or sometimes we give an advice, those sentences are called as imperative sentence. Then last, if you see how careful he is, now here we are expressing a feeling. How careful he is means I am expressing something, I am expressing a strong feeling over here. So that's why that type of sentence is called as exclamatory sentence. So that type of sentence is called as exclamatory sentence. Now these are the four kinds of sentences. These are the four kinds of sentences. First one is declarative, because we are stating something about a noun, or we are telling something about someone. So that's why it is called as declarative sentence. Second is he careful? And we have put a question mark, because we want to get an answer, and we are asking a question. So that's why when we are asking a question, that kind of sentence is called as interrogative sentence. And the third, if you see, be careful means I am giving an order, or I am sometimes we may request also, or sometimes we may give an advice. So that kind of sentence is called as imperative sentence. And the last kind of sentence is exclamatory. Here we express the feelings of our joy, of our sorrow, or sometimes of our surprise. So these are the four kinds of sentences. If you see children, once again we'll revise with the same. What it is? A sentence is a group of words which makes complete sense. See what I told, sentence is a group of words and they make complete sense, but sometimes one word also may be a complete sense of sentence, we can say. One word also may give a meaningful touch, or we can say one word also may help us to understand the what the other person wants to tell you. So it's not necessary only the group of words which make complete sense is a sentence. Sometimes one word also we can say it is a sentence. And what are the four kinds of sentences? There are four kinds of sentences. Which are they? Now see, they have given four examples, and through these four sentences we have found out which are the four kinds of sentences. That is, he is careful. He is careful means we are telling something about him. We are giving an information about him. So this first kind of sentence is declarative sentence. They have told, the first sentence states something. Sentences like this are called statements, or we can say declarative sentences. Second, if you see, is he careful? What it is? In sentence 2, they ask about something. We are asking something about he. So it is a question, means we are asking a question. So sentences of this kind are called as interrogative sentences. And third, if you see, sentence 3 tells somebody to do something, means I am giving, somebody is giving an order. Sentences like this are called as commands or imperative sentences. Here you can see they may have command also, request also, or an advice also. And last, if you see sentence 4, how careful he is, it expresses a strong feeling. So this type of sentences, they are called as exclamations or exclamatory sentences. Now further, if you go, same example, see now, through one type of sentence also we can learn all the thing. Now next examples, if you see what they have given, the first sentence, the film has come out on video. Now we are talking about one film, that it has come out on video means we are stating something. We are telling something more about this film. So that is called as this kind of sentence is declarative sentence, or we can say it is a statement. And second, if you see, what time do you usually get up? Now I am asking a question. Suppose I am asking to you only. Children, what time do you usually get up? I am asking you the question, that what time do you usually get up? I am asking a question. So this is interrogative sentence. Third one, turn down the TV. Now I am giving a command, I am giving an order, that turn down the TV. Your mother, sometimes she shouts on you or she scolds you, isn't it? If you are watching whole day the TV, what she tells you, that turn down the TV, now it's time for your study. So here also I am giving an order, so that is a command. So this kind of sentence is imperative sentence. And the last, if you see, what a clever girl. Now I am expressing my feeling over here, that really she is very clever, and I am expressing my feelings towards this girl. So here it is exclamation, or we can say it is an exclamatory sentence. So these are the four kinds of sentence. First one is declarative, second is interrogative, third is imperative, and the fourth one is exclamatory. I hope, children, you have understood these all four kinds of sentences. Now next, what they have given here, the basic use of an imperative sentence is to give an order. We also use this type of sentence, I told you children, to give advice. In imperative sentence we can see, here only order is not given. I told you just now that we give an advice also. What example they have given? See, learn to use the internet. Now I am giving you an advice. Children, now you all are studying online. So I am giving an advice to you, that you have to know how to use the internet. So I am giving I am advising you that you should learn to use the internet. And next, if you see, make an offer. Example, have a cup of tea means if I want to request, okay, I want to offer you something, or we can say if I want to request you. Here now what they have given, make an offer. Example, have a cup of tea, I want to offer you something. Then I'm going to say like this, have a cup of tea, so I'm offering you something. And one more thing is what, here we can say request is also there. We can say like this, I can say like this, please give me a glass of water, means I am requesting you. So these are some of the sentences which we use in imperative sentence. Then if you see, one more thing, in case of imperative, you see, see here what they have given. Imperative sentence, we can say many things are there. For example, now they have given, first one is what it was, first one it was command or an order, second it was we can see an advice, third it was an offer, fourth is make a wish for somebody. Now sometimes children, you know, whenever if your friend's birthday is there or any function is there or any celebrations are there, that time what you do, or any festival is there, that time what you do, you wish them, isn't it? So here also make a wish for somebody. Example, have a happy journey. Suppose if somebody is traveling, what we do, we give them a wish. Then what we make a wish, that have a happy journey. So this is also, this type of sentence is used in imperative sentence. Then warn somebody, what we do, even we warn them, we give a warning, don't touch that wire. Children, you all have, sometimes they have that habit of touching the wire with the wet hands, and what we do, we warn, we many times we warn that, don't touch the wire or else you will be, you will get the shock of that, or you may get hurt. So you go on warning, but sometimes we don't listen. So warning is also one type of imperative sentence. And give instructions. Example, take 1 teaspoonful every 3 hours. So here also sometimes we give an instructions. So these are some of the sentences which we use in imperative kind of sentence. First one is what? We use it as an order. Second, we use it as an advice. Third, we use it as an offer. Next, we as for the wish. Next, for warning. And last, for instruction. So these are the 4 kinds of sentences. Once again, I will tell you, first is declarative sentence, where we give the information or we state something about someone else. And second is interrogative sentence, here we ask the questions. Third is imperative sentence, here what we do, we give command, we give advice, we give instructions, or we make a wish, we warn somebody else, or what we do, we make an offer also. So these are the imperative sentence. And the last is exclamatory sentence, where we express our strong feelings. So I hope children, you have understood the kinds of sentences. Now if you see, one exercise is there over here, that write 12 sentences of your own. 3 statements means 3 declarative sentence, 3 questions, 3 imperative sentence, and 3 exclamations. So you are going to write 3 sentences in your notebook. But before that, I will give you 2 examples, and you can copy down it now. So I will be writing 2 examples for you, and so that you can copy down those sentences. Children, as I am writing, you can also write along with me roughly, and then you can ferret it out. See, now next, first type of sentence, declarative sentence. I will write one example for you. First is declarative. 2 examples I will write. Okay, that is Kunal is an intelligent boy. This is declarative sentence. Second, Ashoka was a great ruler. These are the declarative sentences. These are the 2 declarative sentences. And one more name is there for declarative sentence, we can say assertive also. The other name is for declarative sentence is assertive sentence. So these are the 2 sentences for example. You can copy down over there or in your notebook. Now second is interrogative sentence. For example, have you finished your breakfast? And you are going to put a question mark because this is interrogative sentence. And one more, when will you go to the market? And put a question mark. So these are the two sentences for interrogative. For declarative sentences, Kunal is an intelligent boy, means we are telling something about Kunal, and Ashoka was a great ruler, we are talking about Ashoka, means we are stating something or we are declaring something about these two. So these sentences are called as a declarative sentence or assertive sentence. And if you see, the second one is interrogative sentence. Here I am asking some questions, that have you finished your breakfast, and I have put a question mark because I am asking a question. When will you go to the market? I am asking a question. So when I am asking a question, that kind of sentence is interrogative sentence. Now the third type is, or third kind of sentence is imperative. Third is imperative. So here I am going to write the sentences. Don't talk. In the class, I am giving an order, and here full stop. Next is, please open the door, means here I am requesting you. So when I am giving a command, or when I am requesting you, or I am giving an advice, so that time those sentences, they are called as imperative sentence. And last is exclamatory sentence. Last is exclamatory. So for example, if I'll give like this, how exciting the trip was. How exciting the trip was, and I have put an exclamation mark. And last sentence, what an interesting match it was. Match it was. So here also I have put an exclamation mark. So these are, third one is imperative sentence, where we give a, or we give an order, we request, or we give an advice. And exclamatory sentence, here we express the sudden feelings. I hope children, you all have understood this topic, that is sentences. Once again, sentence is a group of words which make complete sense, and there are four kinds of sentences: declarative, second is interrogative, third is imperative, and the last is exclamatory. So you have to write at least two sentences of these kind of sentences in your notebook, and even I will be giving you the sentences. I hope children, you have understood through this topic, sentences. Have a good day. Thank you.